next to Guinness Walker, your first goal at Plough Lane in front of fans on Saturday. How did that feel?
Yeah, no, it was a great feeling. Obviously, on a personal note, starting off my goal scoring for the campaign and getting a very valuable point on the weekend in front of the Wimbledon fans as well. So it was great for us to share that with them.
There's a real buzz about the place at the end, wasn't it? What was it like to be a part of?
Yeah, we just have to thank the fans for sticking with us and giving us that extra boost to kick on and get something from the game.
And your level now in the scoring stakes with your old mate Ethan Chislett, who's going to win that battle?
I'm going to have to back myself. I'm hoping to, obviously starting, that's my first goal there. Hopefully I've got some more to come this season and help the team get some more points on the board.
Do you think that the fight back and that kind of mentality perhaps comes from a lot of the players have won their own personal battles coming through non-league, including yourself?
Yeah, I think that could have something to do with it. Obviously, just playing for Wimbledon, we all know what it means to be a Wimbledon player and pulling on that shirt. So for us, we know we have to give everything every time we're out on that pitch. So I think it just comes with playing for Wimbledon.
This afternoon, you've been involved in some meetings all about that personal touch and, you know, making those improvements on the pitch. What have you been doing today?
Oh, today was a light one because obviously we've got the game tomorrow on Tuesday and we're still recovering. But we just went through some off the ball work, working on having a solid shape and making sure that we're hard to beat and that we're not giving away sloppy goals and we're going to help us get those points on the weekend and start picking up some wins. So yeah, just going through that really today. We'll take that into tomorrow.
And I know you're a player who prides himself on the attacking side of things, you know, being able to support the attack, but do you think that part of your game has improved?
Yeah, I feel like I have since I've come here, just being more of an attacking threat. Obviously, I've still got a lot more that I've got to give and want to improve on, so hopefully I can just start chipping in and helping the team get some points.
And there's certainly been goals from all around the team. They've really been shared around. Does it make it really enjoyable to be involved with something like this?
Yeah, definitely. The quality throughout the squad is undeniable when you look through the type of players we have and their own individual attributes. So that's a massive positive and confidence. We go into a game that we haven't got one sole source of goals that it can pop up from anywhere. So hopefully many more to come and we'll just keep working on that.
And your goal on Saturday, originally that came from the other full-back, Shea Alexander. Is that a big part of training, the full-backs joining the attack whenever they get a chance?
Yeah, definitely. Robbo's given us licence to join in going forward as long as we're doing our defensive jobs. So that's great for us, for both being able to go forward, get involved in the attacks, and like I said, I'm happy to pop up with the goal.
Another long trip coming up to Lincoln. How do you pass the time with the lads?
Me? I usually sleep on the train, if I'm honest.
Do you? You're one of them.
I like having my naps. But no, either some of the boys play cards or watch Netflix, just have a chat on the train, talk some football, how we're going to win the game, and we'll go into a game confident.
Judging by the music at the training ground, you must be a deep sleeper then.
I don't know who's on DJ today. There's been a few rogue tunes today, but it's all right.
What would be your choice?
I'll go old school probably. What have I been listening to recently? Otis Redding I've been listening to.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Well before your time.
Yeah.
Who's your roommate?
Rudy.
Okay.
Yeah, me and Rudy. He's got a good education of music as well, to be fair.
He
likes a bit of Biggie Smalls, a bit of Tupac.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to put him on some Otis Redding this weekend and see how we go.
Classic, and he's doing well himself. What's he make of his contribution today?
He's had a great start to the season and long may it continue. Everyone knows the talent that Rudy's got and what he's got to offer, so hopefully he can just keep doing what he's doing, popping up with goals and assists and helping us move up the table.
A nice touch from him as well with picks. He wore the 39 onto his shirt. How important is it as a squad that we remember people that you used to be close to?
Obviously, Pigs was a massive part of what we did here, and he's been here for a long time and contributed so much to this club. So we found out just before kick-off, so we thought as a group it was only right for us to show our condolences and that our thoughts were with him at this time.
Yeah. And in terms of tomorrow night at Lincoln, we've been on our travels and got some really good results this season. What will it take? What are the characteristics we need to show again on Tuesday night?
Yeah, we just try and have the mentality that we're going to go and implement our own identity, home or away. So we'll be having that same mentality tomorrow. We're going to go to Lincoln and impose ourselves on the game and hopefully come away with a win.